In the energy quadrant, taking a look at a down day in the December crude oil. First down session in the last four for crude oil. Crude oil went down and broke that $83 level to the downside with a low of about $82.92. That was down 1.34%, getting almost to 84.5. 84.41 was the high. That was up about 0.4% from yesterday's 84.05 settlement, but we did settle below 84, but above 83. Reclaimed that $83 level to settle the day down only a little bit less than a half of 1%. Again, first down session in the last four. We're not gonna read too much into this because it really wasn't much of a move in terms of the overall range. Now, refinery utilization has been one of the topics that's come up after all the EIA reports, which we have another one coming out tomorrow. And you see, saw refinery utilization tick up a little bit to 85 and change on the last report. Keep an eye on that going forward, as historically we're right in line where October generally falls as we come out of the summer driving season, go into refinery turnaround. We also had some storms that went through that kind of rushed turnaround along. But as we get into November, which we're in now, you start to see refinery utilization on the demand side tick up back into the 90s. That'll be very interesting because it could potentially drive prices higher when you consider the level of stockpiles, especially here in the U.S. OPEC last week said that prices were high because stockpiles were low in the U.S., but this weekend we had Jennifer Granholm, the U.S. Secretary of Energy, basically blame OPEC for higher prices, saying that it's a global market and is controlled by a cartel, and they're not putting enough, I'm paraphrasing, but they're not putting enough crude oil into the market. That's what the U.S. Energy Secretary said in response to OPEC blaming low U.S. stocks as the reason for such higher prices. But having said that, today, a little bit of relief for consumers, down right around a half of 1%, a little bit less than that.